objective lies at the heart of the Isle. The third will remain to guard the ship, while the second patrols the perimeter and eliminates any threats. The first will come with me to secure the research facility. Let no man doubt the import of our mission. The Allegans found a means to capture Icons alive, and their knowledge lies hid upon this isle. If we can but acquire it, we would be able to prevent the beings from returning to plague us, thus ending the cycle of rebirth. I need not remind you that success will raise our legion high in the Emperor's regard. Yet, by the same token, his Radiance does not tolerate failure. That is all. All troops, prepare for deployment!
So that is their purpose.
To think that the knowledge used to bind no less a being than Bahamut sleeps here.
Imprisoning a primal in such a manner would represent an effective means to halt the cycle of summoning, were it not for the grave and obvious risks.
Indeed. We need but refer to past experience, that of Bahamut's calamitous return, to see why this is not the solution we seek.
Held in duress, a primal will continue to nurse its hatred for mankind. And when it inevitably breaks free, its rage will be beyond quelling.
Whatever folly the Garlians mean to commit, they can wait. We must remain focused on our task.
Yes, of course. It would not be polite to keep the Archbishop waiting.
Thank you.
explain my men's silence. We meet again. And this time, we will not be interrupted. keep them occupied.
You must continue on. We will hold them here.
Take the eye. It should still hold enough energy to be of use to you. I shall join you as soon as I am able.
Enough talk. Make haste and stop the Archbishop.
Thank you. Tiamatikin. Etkin? Inches? Nes. An Neshkasni is an Ineska.
The light abideth within thy heart again. Full valiantly didst thou overcome thy many trials. But glory not in thy success. For the servants of darkness are ever close at hand. Receive of me my blessing once more. And go forth to shine thy light on all creation.
Thou hast broken down the wall I built around thee, and partaken of thy mistress's blessing once more. Strong art thou, mortal, stronger than any other of thy kind. Having looked upon thy deeds, I am convinced thou art worthy to bear her light. The covenant bound me to thee, but 'twould seem our fates were mingled from the first. Though I will not fight thy battles, I will yet lend thee my wings.
Enough!
the champion of Hydaelyn.
Tell me, why do you despise the primals so? They are the embodiment of mortal will, of mortal desire. Plainly, you desire a foe to despise, and 'tis well that you do, for it is from the vortex of ceaseless conflict that Lord Zodiac shall be reborn.
Through the joining, the world shall become whole again. Then all shall be as once it was, as it should ever have remained.
For the glory of Lord Zodiac.
Your meddling ends here and now, Warrior of Light.
Darkness shall consume light. No, I will not be bested by the likes of them. La Habrea, it is time.
Very well. Let us show these mortals the true power of the Echo. The power to break down the barriers of existence.
One.
that he might regain the blessing of light I had foreseen. But he has grown so strong in it as to deny us our power.
Let us withdraw, Lahabrea. That power remains to us, at least.
So, you harness the Eye's power. A pity you spent it all. What will you do now, hero?
So, not even the vaunted Warrior of Light can unmake an Ascian without relying upon mortal contrivances. In the distant past, King Thordon and his Knights 12 fought and defeated Nidhogg. Though the victory cost them dear, they were rewarded with a great prize, the dread worm's eyes, both of which have since been held in the Holy See's safekeeping. The eye you possess was Nidhogg's left, and long has it served as a source of the Azure Dragoon's might. As for its twin, it has lain here, joined to the person of Haldreth, the first Azure Dragoon. For though he learned to harness its power, he was ultimately consumed by it. Even in death, his body decays not. A pitiful end for a fabled hero. My Ascian friend, long have you and your kind sown the seeds of chaos by teaching mortals the secrets of summoning. But if you assumed that we would meekly serve as your pawns, then you are gravely mistaken.
You would raise a hand against us.
By taking unto my flesh the soul of the legendary King Thordon, I can become a god!
Thank you. has not cessation, whose being is sustained by a millennium of fervent prayer and the eyes nigh bottomless reservoir of ether.
What?
Your contempt for man has proven your undoing, Ascian. For my first act as God King, I do hereby sentence you to die! Issue with my godhood, I shall answer you with my blade.